Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlace Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily topic wise news analysis where I'll be covering the news from Hindu and Indian Express. So the USP of this initiative is that we try to cover most important point that is covered in the newspaper, and at the same time the coverage of the news is so holistic so that you can easily answer the prelims and mains question. So let's get started with the topic first. So today's 2nd of November, and these are the list of the topic so I'll be discussing with you. So the first topic is Gilgit Baltistan issues. The second is now FIR for the cyber crime. The third topic is GST inflow crosses 1 crore rupees. So this is a good signal in terms of the economic development. Now the fourth topic is UK government announced coronavirus lockdown. So this is the first country that has announced lockdown after 6 months of the coronavirus epidemic. And the last topic, shifting trajectory of Indian foreign policy. So these are some of the news and editorial that has been covered in today's newspaper. Apart from the news, I'll be discussing some MCQs question at the end of this video and the explanation of previous question. The Saturday ke questions the, usko aaj explanation ke saath discuss karenge. So stay tuned till end of this video. And those of you who have cleared prelims this year, so this is the time that you have to enroll for your test series. So we are offering a mains assessment program. This is the test series for CSE mains 2020. So what you can do, you can check the description of this video where I've provided the link to directly register for this in program, and you can also get a discount for that. So do check the description section of this video where you'll find the detail about it. Now coming to the news, that is Gilgit Baltistan issues. So this is an important news which has been there in the news in terms of international relation. So aapke general studies ke paper 2 ke liye this is very much relevant, and I'll also tell you where is the Gilgit issues and how the map arises and what are the concerns that India has. So let's get started with the content. So the Indian government has slammed the Pakistan its attempt to accord the provincial status to the Gilgit Baltistan issues. So wahan pe recently basically kal jo news aayi hai wahan ke jo PM hai, the Pakistan PM has announced that they would be giving the provincial status to this region, right? Now India clearly stated ki unki jo intention hai, that is a camouflage of illegal occupation in the region, and Pakistan is trying to aggregate that region, controlling that, right? So giving the provincial status because this region is under the disputed land between the India and Pakistan, right? And India already has stated that this is under the territorial jurisdiction of India. So we'll see the map also. So what is India's stand? First, I'd like to clear the Indian government stand. So the Ministry of External Affairs, they have firmly rejected, they have outstandingly rejected that the Pakistan is trying to bring some material change in the Indian territory, which is under Pakistan illegal and forcible occupations. So these points are very relevant when you're writing in the mains examination, you have to quote same sentence, right? Now, India has previously reiterated that the UT of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, including the Gilgit Baltistan, is integral part of the India, and this is by the virtue of legal and reinforceable accession of Jammu and Kashmir with the Union of India in 1947. And the government of Pakistan has no loci stand. Locus stand ka matlab hota hai ki uski kisi bhi tarah se koi responsibility nahi banti hai, koi jurisdiction nahi banti hai. No loci stand on the territory that is illegally and forcibly occupied by the Pakistan. Now what Pakistan government has announced, the Pakistan government has recently announced that they would be holding the legislative election. They have announced the provincial autonomy, which indeed would be looking forward for the legislative assembly in the Gilgit Baltistan later in the month. And in this area, in this ruler, basically agar baat kare abhi ke kuch time se, to Pakistan ke Supreme Court ne ye allowed kiya hai Pakistan ko ke they could amend 2018 administrative order to conduct the general election in that region. So this region is the Gilgit region, right? Now the Gilgit Baltistan order 2018 provide for the administrative changes, including the Prime Minister of Pakistan to legislate the array of subjects. बहुत सारे subjects और area confined किए गए हैं Supreme Court के द्वारा वहाँ के government को कि किस किस area में वो laws बना पाएंगे. Now let's look into the map. So this is the exact map of the Gilgit Baltistan area, and this is a line of actual control. This is a line of control. This is a sky chain, Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir. And this very short area is the POK, right? POK stands for Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. And this is the area to be ceded by the China, Pakistan. So this is the entire map. That is the reason that India has been always provocating that this region belongs to India, right? Now coming to the other topic, that is now FIR for the cyber crime, because there's an unprecedented increase in the cyber crime, and because of which the government has decided they would be lodging FIR in every cyber crime that was reported, right? So this is equally important for your general studies paper 2, and these type of point would be relevant for your general studies paper 4 in the case study, right? So case study mein is tarah ke cheezon ko use kar payenge. Now the recent directive jo hamari union home ministry jo hamari grih mantralay hai, oh, they have said that they're writing a letter to the state government to examine and register FIR based on the complaint that is received on the national cybercrime reporting portal. So NCRP, this is the portal which government has provided. So in this portal, any individual who is facing the cyber crime, cyber fraud can directly report their complaint, and that report from now onwards would be treated as an FIR, and the police has to take concrete actions with that. Now as per the data available with the ministry, only 2.5% of the total complaint were registered. जितने भी टोटल केस रिपोर्ट किए गए हैं उसमें सिर्फ 2.5% केसेस को पुलिस ने एफआईआर जो फर्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन रिपोर्ट है उसमें रजिस्टर्ड किया है, नॉट ऑल द केसेस, राइट? नाउ इट वुड बी मैंडेटरी जितने भी केसेस जो कंप्लेन वहां रिपोर्ट होंगे उस पोर्टल में, दैट वुड बी काउंटेड एज एन एफआईआर. नाउ व्हेन द पोर्टल वॉज लॉन्च्ड, बात करें जो ये पोर्टल है इसको लॉन्च किया गया था नेशनल साइबर क्राइम रिपोर्टिंग पोर्टल को अगस्त 2019 में, एंड द पोर्टल हैज रिसीव्ड ओवर 2 लाख कंप्लेन, बट द एफआईआर हैज रजिस्टर्ड ओनली 5000 केसेस. 2 लाख केसेस में सिर्फ 5000 केसेस पे ही एफआईआर लॉन्च की गई है. नाउ द सीनियर गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल ऑन द एवरेज दे हैव सेड कि 100,000 साइबर क्राइम कंप्लेन वॉज रिसीव्ड every month across the country, and this number is gradually increasing from every part of the country. Now advantages of the portal, the government which has enacted the portal has some major advantages. So the first is that the ministry says it aim to raise the group of cyber crime volunteer to flag the unlawful content on the internet. So any activities which like prone hindrance to the national security and other issues would be treated as an unlawful content. And good smartarian would be welcome to register the cyber crime. The unlawful content, the unlawful content would be again taken into the action, because the law enforcement agencies would have to identify who among the following has raised the complaint and who is actually doing it, reporting it, and removal of the illegal and unlawful content from the internet. Now the unlawful content is characterized as the content against the sovereignty and integrity of India. कोई भी ऐसी content, कोई भी ऐसी video, ऐसे blogs जो कि India के sovereignty और integrity, जो प्रभुता और अखंडता को जो भी किसी भी तरह से खराब करती है, उसको that would be treated as a crime. Now against the defense of the India, any issues that is related to the security of state, किसी राज्य के या किसी भी स्टेट को अगर उससे प्रॉब्लम है, इट्स अगेन अनलॉफुल कंटेंट है, नेशनल इश्यूज को अराइज करती है, सो दैट वुड बी ट्रीटेड एज अनलॉफुल कंटेंट. एंड अगेंस्ट एनली फ्रेंडली रिलेशन फॉरेन नेशंस, सो दिस आर द लाइक डिस्टर्बिंग पब्लिक ऑर्डर, डिस्टर्बिंग कॉमनल हारमोनी, एंड एनी कंटेंट रिलेटेड टू द चाइल्ड सेक्स अब्यूज वुड बी ऑल्सो ट्रीटेड एज अनलॉफुल कंटेंट. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द कैटेगरीज दैट कैरेक्टराइज द अनलॉफुल कंटेंट. Now rising number, because gradually what has happened, the number has been steadily increasing. So according to that, the government has compiled the National Crime Record Bureau, jo NCRB, unke mutabik the number of the cyber crime has increased by 63%. So this is a stunning numbers which is coming. So 63.5% is a gradual increase compared to the year 2019 with the previous year data. So this is more than 50% of the cases has been reported, more than compared to the previous year 2019. Now again, helpline was also been provided for the victim. So the portal has started the helpline for the victim who has financial cyber fraud especially in Delhi, and they would have to dial a number called 155260. So this has to report on the incident, and there's a portal which is dedicated portal called cybercrime.gov.in. So any individual, if you are also a part of this, and if you have encountered any of the cybercrime or any of your relatives are there, you can also directly report this crime on www.cybercrime.gov.in. And on receiving the complaint, the designated police, after receiving and verifying the matters, what they are doing, they are completely tracking the financial intermediaries, the wallet payment that is involved with any of the individual, and they try to freeze the account, right? So, किसी भी तरह से कोई भी अगर cyber fraud होती है, तो Delhi में experimental basis पे the helpline has already been started. Now, this would be expanding gradually to Pan India. Now, the other topic, that is GST inflow crosses 1 lakh crore rupees. So this is again relevant for your general studies paper 2, and some parts here and there may be again relevant for the prelims examination. So in the recent announcement, the government has cited that jo GST ke inflow hai wo 1 lakh crore se zyada ki mark cross ki hai. This is for the first time in the financial year after the COVID-19 pandemic. And the tax inflow is a clear sign that economy is recovering after it's 23.9% contraction. So economy mein jo contraction dekhi gayi thi, it's like 23.9% or it is 24% approximate. So first quarter mein ye jo data is aayi thi, usse ye pata chala. Now as per the data released by the Ministry of Finance, jo ki Sunday ko release ki gayi thi, so jo revenue ki collection hai, that is 1,5155 crore rupees, which is 10.25 times highest than the year ago. जो पिछले साल में इस time में जो tax की collection हुई थी, उससे 10.25% ज़्यादा है ये, and 10.1% more than the indirect taxes revenue garnered in the month of September. So recovery signal has been shown in the economy in terms of the tax collection. Gradually we can have some positive aspects of this as well. Now this is a infographic which will help you understand how the gradual increase has been there. So the GST collection has recorded 10.2, which I have told you in the beginning, and this is like GST collection, and this is year over year changes. So this is YOY, that is year over year changes. So you can see from April, May, June, every year it was a gradual increase, and in October there was sudden increase which has recorded to 1,5155 lakh crore rupees. Now what are the expert opinion? We certainly do not need to be on a cushion mode, because this is something which would take another downturn. So the tax expert has expected that the shortfall in the GST compensation to the state could be lower, because it was estimated that is bar ki jo present jo valuation ki gayi hai wo 2.35 lakh crore rupees ki gayi, but abhi bhi we are on the halfer side. And however, the economics business have again cautioned sustainability of this trend. Ye trend kitne lambe samay tak barqarar rahegi, iski sustainability kitni hogi, is pe abhi bhi sandeh barqarar hai. So these are some of the important expert opinion that is coming with regards to the tax collection. Now previous growth ki agar baat kare, so what was the estimation? So the previous growth, the revenue compared to that of the month, and August, July, September ki agar baat kare, so it was in July it was -14%, in August it was 8%, and in September it was 5% respectively. So these shows the trajectory of the recovery of the economy corresponding of the revenues. Now coming to the other topic, that is UK government has announced coronavirus lockdown. So this would be again important for your general studies paper 2 in general, right? So the lockdown announced Saturday by the Prime Minister Boris Johnson, and he has said that till Thursday, that is until 2nd of December, they would be continuing the lockdown in United Kingdom. And unlike UK, the 3-month lockdown which was earlier also, the universities, school, construction site, manufacturing business will still be open, right? Inko band nahi kiya jayega, in sare categories ko abhi bhi exempted rakha gaya. Now, jo decision li gayi hai UK government ki, that has announced in the national lockdown in England. Initially, abhi 4-week ki plan ki gayi hai. Agar zarurat padi, to they can also increase it to the other number. That is again the prerogative of the Prime Minister. And under the new restriction, the bar of the restaurant and other can offer the takeaway, and non-essential shops must close. Jo bhi non-essential items ke aise cheeze hain, unko band rakha jayega. And people would be more offered to shortlist, including their exercise and work, and preferably they are advised to work from ना ब्रिटेन इज द वर्स्ट डेथ रेट. अगर यूरोप की पूरी बात करें तो सबसे ज़्यादा जो डेथ के केसेस रिपोर्ट किए गए हैं वो ब्रिटेन में, दैट नंबर इज 46,500 एंड ओवर 1 million कन्फर्म्ड केसेस हैव बीन रिपोर्टेड टिल सैटरडे. सो लाइक द यूरोपियन कंट्रीज, वायरस यूके में भी बिगिन हुई थी लॉकडाउन के बाद, बहुत सारी केसेस उन्होंने भी कंट्रोल की, बट द रिटर्न ऑफ द वर्क प्लेस, स्कूल, यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड सोशल लाइफ हैन अगेन रेज द नंबर ऑफ द कोरोना वायरस पेशेंट्स. So this is something which government wanted to curb and flatten the curve of the coronavirus. Now the other last topic, that is shifting trajectory of Indian foreign policy. This is written by M.K. Narayanan. He is a former governor of the West Bengal and he is former NSA, National Security Advisor. So he wrote in the Hindu about the shifting trajectory in the Indian foreign policy. So this is again very important for your general studies paper too, because many fodder point would be relevant for your examinations. So the third India-US 2+2 ministerial dialogue that was there recently concluded between the foreign and defense ministry level, and also US secretaries and defense, they have marked the shifting trajectory of the India and US relation. We'll be considering other countries as well, but this is more or less talking about the Indo-US relation, right? So what is the strategic focus between these two countries? The centerpiece of the dialogue was the signing of the Basic Exchange of the Cooperation Agreement. This is known as BECA. और BECA जो है वो आपके prelims examination point of view से बहुत बहुत ही ज़्यादा important है. Make sure that you learn all the point about it. We already had a discussion on our analysis video. So for geospatial corporations, right? Now, this agreement marked the entry of the full membership into the select category and entitled to receive the clarified US defense and intelligence information. अब इसके advantages ये होगी कि जो BECA agreement India ने sign किया है, उसके बाद US के तरफ से कुछ important geospatial जो services हैं, जो maps हैं, वो सारे India को वापस benefits मिलेंगे, and this would be again boosting the security and defense cooperation of India, augmenting from the other countries. Like, तो इस तरह के पहले services India के पास नहीं थी. Now, meeting the direct existing bilateral cooperation, including the military-to-military cooperation, securing communication system, infographic sharing, defense, trade, industrial issues at the new level. So, this would be taking a toll in terms of all the categories which is shown here. So, you can write step by step, like military-to-military cooperation, secure communications, information sharing, and defense and trade. So these are some of the area where India and US would be working together and augmenting their relationship to a higher level, right? Now coming to the important bilateral agreements. So while the signing of BECA, India is now a signatory to all the US related foundational military agreements. So these military agreements is somewhere going to boost the India-US relation, and invariably India would be again having a strong military. बेसिकली बेस जो मिलिट्री की जो हमारी सारी फोर्सेस की एक नेवी, आर्मी, ये सारी चीज़ें बहुत स्ट्रांग होगी. नाउ इंडिया हैज़ ऑल्सो साइंड द लॉजिस्टिक एक्सचेंज मेमोरेंडम एग्रीमेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड लियोमा इन 2016 एंड द कम्युनिकेशन कंपैटिबिलिटी सिक्योरिटी एग्रीमेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड कॉम कैसा इन 2018. तो कभी भी आप इंडो यूएस रिलेशनशिप लिखें तो ये सारे पॉइंट्स एग्रीमेंट्स यू हैव टू मस्ट राइट, राइट? दिस इज सम ऑफ द मैंडेटरी पॉइंट. Now by appending the signature to the BECA, now India is in the position to specify and receive the sensitive geospatial intelligence जो है, जो BECA की जो agreement हुई है, उससे India को इसके added advantage मिलेगी कि सारे geospatial important informations India के साथ US share करेगी. Now क्या impact हुए हैं इसके China में? तो China is like, you know, they're feeling fragmented because India ने जिस तरह से US के साथ अपनी relationship बढ़ाई है, तो China is more concerned with the, you know, they think that India is going anti-China. But for instances, they have also, India ने जो quad members अभी बनाए हैं, जो हमारी naval exercise हो रही है, मालाबार की जो exercise है, उसमें जो 4 countries हैं, वो एक बहुत ही important segment, अभी Australia को recently join कर लिया गया, Australia, Japan, India and United States. So these are the country that would be taking part in the quad agreement. जो quad है, मालाबार naval exercise की, वो कहीं ना कहीं China के लिए एक संकेत है, एक संदेह है, कि इनकी relationship अच्छी हो रही, what we need to do, right? So China is again serious about this. नाउ रशिया लिंक की भी बात की गई है यहाँ पे, कि कैसे रशिया के लिंक को हमें अच्छी करनी है, बिकॉज जिस तरह से रशिया यूएस की तरफ थोड़ा इंक्लाइंड है, सो यूएस एंड चाइना, सो दे हैव टू सी हाउ देयर फॉरेन रिलेशन कुड गो, बिकॉज इंडिया के लिए रशिया एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट पार्टनर रहा है, चाहे वो मिलिट्री की एग्रीमेंट्स हो, चाहे वो S-400 मिलिट्री इक्विपमेंट्स हो, मिसाइल सिस्टम हो, सब चीज़ों ने रशिया ने इंडिया को देने की कोशिश की है। तो दिस इज़ द टाइम कि रशिया चाइना की तरफ इंक्लाइन ना हो, बिकॉज इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि हमारा रशिया के साथ रिलेशनशिप अच्छा बरकरार रहे। एंड दिस इज़ द टाइम दैट रशिया चाइना रिलेशन हैव अ वास्टली एक्सपेंडेड स्ट्रेटजिक कंग्यूरेंस एंड इंडिया विड नीड टू हैंडल द रिलेशनशिप विच इज़ कंटिन्यूइंग फॉर पास्ट 70 ईयर्स। एक बहुत अच्छी रिलेशनशिप है इंडिया और रशिया की, सो दिस शुड नॉट डेटोरेट इन एनी कंडीशन, दैट गवर्नमेंट हैज़ टू इंश्योर, राइट। Now coming to the Saturday questions के जो answers हैं, so will I be spelling the answer and the complete explanation of this. So for the first question, the correct option is B, that arsenic is highly toxic in an inorganic form and arsenic is naturally present at the high level on the groundwater and number of the countries. So these are some of the important points. So I've taken the reference from the NCERT. You can also read NCERT and you can get the complete details about it. Coming to the second question, the correct option here is C, that the NRI bond issued by the Reserve Bank of India in a non-resident who are interested in investing the money in India, since these bonds offer the highest return, so they can be used as a toll for attracting the capital during the domestic asset fail to attract the interest from the foreign investors. An NRI bond could be theoretically help increasing the demand of the rupee and stabilizing the value against the dollar. So many of you are participating in the question answer series. So I want you people should more be involving and writing your answer in any other in general queries that you have. You can also write in the comment section down below. Now coming to the MCQ's question of the day. So the first question is coming from geography. Consider the following statement with regards to ITCZ. It is a low pressure zone located in the equator. It is most active continental landmass by the day and relatively less active over the ocean. So what do you have to do? You have to just choose the options A, B, C, D and write the correct option in the comment section down below, right? Now coming to the second question from the static portion with reference to Young Bengal movement, consider the following statement. The movement was inspired by the American Revolution and it was launched by the Henry Louis Vivian Tenorio. So these are two important points with regards to Young Bengal movement. So you have to tell which among the following is correct. And if you have any additional information about Young Bengal movement, you can share that information with us in the comment section down below, right? So do participate, write your answer in the comment section. And if you're new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe Aptiplus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. And if you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. If you have any other concern, do let us know. We'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.